ticket for the long way round.
I met Keith when I was a new hire and had to go complete some paperwork, going to the Northwest office. All I knew was that he was a bald-headed white guy that was an ex-cop, and I was going to be working with the Department of Juvenile Justice grant, which was his baby, so of course that made me terrified, but he was a real cool guy.
Well, the first time I met Keith was when we were doing my new employee paperwork, and I walked into the office and they were like, here's Keith, and I was like, oh, he's gonna be big and scary. And when I seen him, he was kind of short with a tight muscle shirt on. So I was like, oh, this is gonna be nothing. This is gonna be fine.
When I first met Keith, I actually had no idea he was gonna be as cool as he was. I remember I never really saw him. I just heard about him. He's like, oh yeah, you know, the boss, the CEO, Keith. That's all I heard. And so one day I actually saw him. I was like, oh, he's a really cool guy. You know, real down to earth. You know, sat there and talked to me, and you know, we got a great conversation. I realized, you know, we're in good hands. We have such a great leader like him. He's so, you know, manageable, respectable, you know, his staff. And, you know, he really spoke highly of us. He thought highly of us. And it was really good to see.
I met Keith about 5.5 years ago when I was in college, and I started working here. And I was taking my paperwork to his office, and Mr. Baker was the one who was working here. And he kind of explained Keith as this scary, mythical creature that I should be afraid of. So when I went over there, I was really intimidated and worried. But when I finally met Keith, here comes this charismatic, down-to-earth guy who made me feel so comfortable. And I immediately thought, like, wow, if this organization is in his hands, that I was in.
Random memory would be Keith, his impersonations. His doctor is great, and I'm still trying to get enough drinks in him for him to do Tata Tanisha. I don't even know that's how you say it, but I want to meet that person.
I know one that comes to mind off that is when we had BGC Honors the first time. We were all sitting there talking, eating dinner, and then all of a sudden I see the mojitos come out, and I'm like, oh, okay, so I guess we can have a few drinks with the boss. And that was just something that was that I remember, because I always thought that he was gonna be uptight, and you know, he didn't let loose and drink his mojitos. But it was very fun to spend that time with him and be able to relax and have regular conversation about things.
The fondest memory that I had of Keith is when we had a youth summit with River Phoenix and the Alachua County Sheriff's Department. And you told a story about an instance that you had in California. And just to see your heart for the youth and for people really touched me. And I really realized how much of a good person that you are, and how strong that you are, and how much you care for other people. And I would really say that, you know, that's gonna stick with me for the rest of my life.
My fondest memories of Keith are the times that he spent giving me advice and mentorship and development. With someone with so much on his plate, you would think he wouldn't have time to spend that time or develop us the way that he has. So my fondest memories have always been the extra effort and time he puts into making sure I am the best in my position and preparing me for the next level of my career. And also looking at him as an advocate. Keith is a huge advocate, and I don't know if a lot of people know that, but he fights for those without a voice, and he stands up for what he believes in. And I hope that more executive directors were like that. I really wish more executive directors were like that, and I hope that I can be that type of director as well, because I want to make sure every decision I make has the kids involved, and that's the kind of director Keith is. I've recently noticed Keith's advocacy even in other aspects of his profession, and it meant a lot to me that he would stand up for what he believed in regardless of what anyone has to say. And I think that is the definition of true character, standing up regardless of what anyone thinks, knowing that you stay true to your morals and ethics. And that's the type of director that I want to be, and I truly, truly look up to.
Q Keith would probably melt all stupid people. He really doesn't like dumb people. And I enjoy that. I really do enjoy it. I think that's what he would melt stupid people.
I would think that Keith would be the Hulk. And I say this because I've seen Keith, like, be the sweetest person. But as soon as you mess with somebody that he loves or someone he cares for, he can get real bold and strong. And, of course, because of this last year, everything he's gone through, he's been strong and conquered it all with a smile on his face. So that's something that I feel as if he would be if he had superpower.
If Keith had a superpower, I would say he would be one of the guys off Fantastic Four, the one who can stretch to be everywhere all the time, because I always feel like he knows what's going on every you know, second of the day. You know, his eyes and ears everywhere. He really has a lot of clout gains. A lot of people know Keith, and they speak very highly of him. That speaks volumes of his character. He's a great guy, he's a great person to work with and work for.
So I don't know what Keith's superpowers would be, but I know who he would be if he was a superhero. And it would be Batman, because Keith thinks he's Batman. And I know that because all of his passwords are Batman. But he is an awesome, awesome person, and I think that he would be an awesome superhero just like Batman.
Here I am waiting, I'll have to leave soon. Why am I holding on? We knew this day would come, we knew it all along. How did it come so fast? This is our last night, but it's late, and I'm trying.
Great knowing you. I've learned a lot about myself as a professional underneath your watch. Good luck in all that you do. I really appreciate all the trust that you put in me personally regarding DJJ. I know it's a big part of Boys and Girls Club and keeping lights and things on, so thank you for your trust. Hope I didn't let you down, and good luck.
Keith, I'm gonna miss you so much. This last year or two, we've grown really, really close. And I never thought at the beginning of this process that I would understand a person like you, but I really understand you more and more each day, and I'm really gonna miss your presence here at the Boys and Girls Club of Alachua County. Love you, bye.
I've been on the street for a long time, and so fast right now to leave us. I really wanna leave too with her, but I know I can't. So I guess I better stay here at the Boys and Girls Club where I can keep saying going on, right? Keep Neil in control, and whoever else come in after, especially Mr. Arthur. You know, when he's in there doing his thing, I need to sell him a whole lot of time. It's the kid. Bless Mr. Keith wherever he's going. Please bless him in many, many ways.
Keith, I just want to let you know, even though we haven't really talked as much as you have with everyone else, I really feel like I've been touched by your leadership, your great personality, and great character. I truly believe that wherever you go, they're really getting a great person. Not only a great professional, but a great person with a great heart. I just know how much you care for the kids and how much you care for what you do. And I really believe that you're going to turn some things up wherever you go. And I appreciate that you extended the invitation to, you know, always be there for me. And I truly feel like over these past couple years, I've really gone closer to you and learned how much of a great person that you are. So good luck. Farewell.
I just want to tell you, Keith, that you have been an amazing role model and mentor, and a girl like me couldn't have asked for a better role model. Whether you know it or not, you have been like a father figure to me over the last few years, and your advocacy, your advice, your mentorship has been so much, and you have helped develop me into the professional that I am today. And I know that one day, if I become president of the United States or anything, I will be giving a lot of my credit to you for helping me develop the way that I have, and for trusting me and trusting my talent and ability, where some people wouldn't have. But because you trusted in my talent and abilities, I was able to really reach my full potential, and now, you know, I'm at a point in my career where I'm looking forward, and I'm really excited, and a lot of you. I hope that one day I can work with you again in some capacity, but Tennessee is lucky to have you, and they are definitely going to get taken to the next level. We'll see you guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hello.
You heard me.